So my last video is my cold start of my truck. This video is a gun review. I only did a couple of these, so I'm not good at it, but still good. This right here is my 410 shotgun. It's a Hatfield single shot. Trigger pull. Needs lubed up a little bit. And it's a single shot. You just put it in like this. Okay. How much this is, I already know it. This gun right here, for a little 410 that can shoot anything you want, I am going to demonstrate that. You're going to shoot slugs through it. You're going to shoot pump defense rounds through it. And birdshot. And you don't have to change out a choke or anything like that, because you don't have a choke. So, and I have some bottles that we're going to blow up with birdshot, slugs, and pump defense rounds. So, you probably can see all this stuff, that's just my cleaning stuff. So, it's hammer, then safety, hammer still pulled back after safety, but it's all fine, because it has iron sights, and that's the only thing you can have. It has a little groove, and it's pretty nice gun. I bought this, I come with it. It's $100 at Walmart. Exact same gun you can have, $100 at Walmart. I have also a 22. Savage 64F, but I only killed one squirrel with this, and I took it out a bunch of times, and I missed a ton, which, also I used an iron sights a little far away with the rifle, but then this one, I brought out 5 times, 6 times for squirrel, and slash rabbit, and I got tons of squirrels with this. This is awesome little gun. Just bring the pocket full of bird shot and there you go, you're set. And this gun. And I bought this because it'll be easier to load and stuff like that. I figured it would be easier, so I bought that. And I also added that addition gun. $5 at Walmart. Not bad. I put over 200 rounds through it. Still functioning great. No mishaps. Just clean it when you get it. Clean it after every shot. And you just work this trigger back and forth for a good hour or two. But yeah, pretty good. I love it. I bought this. I actually bought this one at a pawn shop. It's brand new, still at a pawn shop. Never been used at a pawn shop. But yeah, I love it. It pulls up real nice and easy. Yeah, this is really how you get pulled in it. You just pull this. Pull this little thing back right here, the trigger guard, you pull that back like that, and then it goes like that. It's that easy. Got some bird shot right here, put it in there, there you go, it's ready. That's what I used to use. And also, I finally found some slugs for it. Slugs are kind of hard to find, or unless you go to Bass Pro. Or a Cabela or something like that. I'm pretty sure they have a big box of slugs. 25 slugs for it. And the slugs I got are, I think, I don't know. I have some in here. This is my Facebook. No, I don't have it. Okay, well, anyways, here's the slug I got. It looks like a bird cover. Yeah, it's Super X. That's the one I got. And it goes 1,800 feet per second, which I'm going to show that. What's the slug? Why did I do that? But I just used to load it, and it's just so much fun. Yeah, I haven't had that much problem. Had a bullet stock, real heavy duty. Does have, okay, with birdshot, I don't have any range. I can shoot without earplugs, but I'm going to use earplugs for safety reasons. No problem at all. It has bird. It's just little fun little $100 gun you can buy at Walmart. If you're a beginner, I would recommend a 22 to start off with, and then a 410. Because 410 you can pick. Okay, I started off with the AR-15, then I went to a 22, and then shotgun and stuff like that. But then I never shot a 410 until I got this, and I always wanted the 410. And I always did. My stepdad had a 410, but he sold it for another gun. So. And trade the turn over or something like that. But I don't have that in my rifle, it was a bolt action shooting. So I have this one now. $100 at Walmart. Found it. I paid $100 also at the pawn shop, so it was pretty much drunk dealing. Really not big of tech, so, and also you build a lot faster with the other stuff. So, yeah, I like it. Hatfield 410 single shot, $100 at Walmart. You're done. Now, I'm gonna pause the video and probably go outside so when you guys can watch me shoot this at some bird. I'm gonna tell you guys what I'm shooting. Like, bird shot has no, it has a little recoil, but I also has a little no ring to the ears. But when you get up to home defense rounds and slugs, it has a little ring in the ear to pinpoint gunpowder. My slugs go 1,800 feet per second, so yeah. Faster than our 12-gauge, usually 12-gauge shotgun. But this is a little fun little gun. I recommend this gun to teens, I should say. Just teens. Responsible teens, I should say. It's just a little fun little gun. Not that heavy. Well, you put this off, it's not that heavy. This is adding a lot of weight too, though. But yeah, I'm going to shoot. It has iron sights, has a little ball front, and you just have to pull back the hammer to pour it because the iron sight and the hammer is in the way. But, yeah, it's just a little fun little gun. I like it a lot. I don't know if you guys buy one, you guys will like one a lot. So, go out there and buy yourself a 410 shotgun. $100 at Walmart. They also have other guns at Walmart for, I think, $100, which is a Savage 64F and black style. I got a camel style, which is 70-something dollars more, I think. I'm not for sure, actually. I might be wrong on that. I don't know. But I'm going to Walmart today, so I'll check it out. And then we'll update you guys if it is, because I'm going to be doing this video later sometime next week, which is Saturday, January, no, I can't read it, 26, there, got it. But, yeah, it's just a little fun little gun, little easy, really easy to handle, steady. I can hold it just perfectly in one spot forever, and I'm taking a deer hunt because I got slugs for it, which slugs are, I got the box for it. I got more slugs in the basement, but I got 5 slugs for $7, which I finally found slugs, so I bought 2 boxes. But bird shot, I had a home defense round that I could shoot through it, because I had slugs and 2 balls, which you can shoot anything through this gun. You can aim it, you can shoot anything. I will be shooting 4 shot, I think it's called. Yeah, 4 shot bird shot. So it's in a tighter pattern so that I can hit the targets more better and blow them up. So yeah, let me pause the video real quick and get out of the shooting. Thank you.
yeah, I'm gonna shoot at the two right over there. See what they do. Shot at it, and it actually left patterns in the snow, so yeah, it just knocked it over. It's just good for like squirrels and stuff like that. I'm not gonna go real specific that, unless I want to find some BBs or something like that. Prime example, okay, I'm gonna try finding this one shell I just shot. That's,
I don't know when that stopped or something like that. Sure, you should watch the videos, but I was just explaining how, what a 410 slug looks like and bird shot looks like, which I'll do that in a little bit. So now I'm going to shoot way over there.
Again, it just scattered. That was awesome.
So awesome, guys. I love shooting this little thing. It's just so much fun. Now I'm going to shoot 6 more shots. Sorry, guys. I'm going to shoot this kind of fast. Now let's do the last bottle standing.
I have a soda bottle ready for takeoff. If you guys get what I'm trying to say. I don't know if you guys can hear this in the video or see it in the video, but I'm gonna try getting it. There, that should be, you guys should be able to see that if my camera don't fall.
Up in the air and then shoot it. So yeah,
demonstration one shot only. Oh, I missed. Shots, speed run. I'm gonna get my other 2 shots ready. If I can find them. That's a already been shot. I think I got them in my hand. Okay, so that's already been 2 speed shots. Going at it. Okay, speed shots.
Here's my little workbench looking thing. That's a slug. I don't know if you guys saw that, but that's the slug right there. That's what it looks like after it comes out. That's what home defense round looks like, or critical defense looks like if it comes out. And that's what
birdshot looks like. That does not really look like birdshot, but I know it's birdshot because I shot only one slug and it's kind of rounded like a slug. Focus, okay. Forte, oh wait. Yeah, I think I got one more. Right here. Round empty in my pockets, I don't care. Not a pen. Yeah, okay, I don't have any more, but I'm gonna pull out the stuff I found. I don't know what they're called, but real interesting stuff. Okay. There's all I shot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, right. 8, 9, 10 shots. Could have shot 9 shots, but didn't want to. So 11 shots. Okay, so I found these. If anyone watching these videos, my videos, what in the world are these? I honestly don't know. It looks like it's not a slug because it's not metal, it's plastic. Is this what the slug holds into or something like that? Because I've noticed that after I shot the critical defense rounds, and then I also noticed it when I shot this because there's still some out there. But yeah. Okay, now I'm going to show you guys what the bullets did to the things. So this is a slug. This is home defense round. Kind of tore it up pretty good. It's hanging on by a thread. This is also home defense round, but I really didn't get it good enough. Hit it good enough, I should say. This is what I threw up in the air. Bird shot. God dang it. I'll clean it later. I'm cleaning it anyways. Bird shot again. It entered holes. You can see it right there. And exit holes. Really see it. Yeah, but there's actually still a BB in it. Also bird shot. I don't know where I headed that. Somewhere, but it kind of tore it up. And also bird shot. Hit it in the exact same spot, pretty much. Tore it pretty good up. But yeah, probably gonna end the video here. Please like, comment, subscribe, and peace.